Today we're going to look at building an S-Plan heating junction box with the Wago TopJob S DIN rail terminal system.
Are you obsessed with the S-Plan heating system?
I'm traumatised, Gary, ever since we went to that project when we took over the smart home and there was a little bit of a messy job. We've looked at lots of ways of improving it, and one of the early ones we did was with the Wago 207-4301, is the part number.
And I'm going to go, yes, you're correct, because I haven't got a clue what the part number was for that. And I'm looking down here, and I'm not seeing that style of connection box from Wago, but I am seeing a Wago product.
Yeah, so it was based on feedback. So we took that fantastic system and showed you how you could deploy it in an S-Plan heating system and configure it for other ones. I'm not just obsessed with S-Plan, but some of the feedback we got from that was, in some instances, Gary, it's a little bit too big.
What you're saying, that when I get into that area, maybe where a plumber has been, that he's taken up a lot of the real estate in there and left us hardly any room in order to do our connections?
Yeah. And obviously, what's the other problem? Plumbers sort of have their problems sometimes, don't they? We sometimes have leakage in electrical systems, but they sometimes struggle with leakage as well, don't they?
Yeah, so it could be that your enclosure needs an increased IP rating, and that might be not necessarily because we're wondering if their pipe's going to leak, but it can be because of higher humidity and that environment, such as boiler houses, isn't it?
Yeah, so yeah, you're not inside a building, you're outside, and that happens a lot with some of these more renewable-based systems. You need an enormous amount of space, big tanks, and yeah, things do leak from time to time. So we thought we'd look at how we can build a wiring centre.
Right.
Using the top job that we've featured in some previous videos.
Yeah, we don't need to mention all those videos. There's one in that collection you don't need to go back on where I lose, well actually I lost the race because I was given the incorrect equipment. So make sure you get to that part of it and you'll agree with me and leave a comment below on that one. I'm gonna have a look at what you're doing here because I think it looks quite neat. Just explain to me, obviously, first of all, the enclosure that you use for the IP rating.
Okay, so this is an enclosure we've featured before from Hylec, and we've coupled that up with some Kwik cable glands.
Okay, so the Kwik cable glands there, so bring one in, just remind me of the Kwik.
Yeah, so again, so you don't need to put a lock nut on the back, so that creates a very sort of minimal space requirement inside the box.
Yep.
We've got what you'd expect to see on a S-Plan heating system, our power supply coming in there.
Yep.
We've got a 5-core cable going to what would be something like a Nest heat link. So it's a combined thermostat and timer and switch for the water.
Yeah, not just off the board then.
Just off the board, and wireless, Gary, after that bit. These are the aerials. Obviously supply out to the boiler to fire up the boiler, which works also with the pump.
Yep.
Cylinder heating step and two zone valves for the hot water and for the heating system as well.
So pretty much a standard S-Plan arrangement, but of course we're using these here, the top job DIN rail connectors. Shall we just see how we put this box together?
Yeah.
So let's start off with a little bit of overkill.
Yeah, I've got the Milwaukee Force Logic out. See how it cuts clean holes in a plastic enclosure? I know what people are thinking, yeah, you went in with a 12 millimeter hole, why didn't you just carry on? You'd be right. But these holes are very, very neat.
Well, if you got one, use it.
Yeah. So just, so we're gonna start building up our top job DIN rail terminals, the all important end stop to stop the terminal shifting along the DIN rail. And then we're gonna bring in the earth connection, putting the end cap on. A lot of people forget these, but that's to obviously connect our earth conductors, but also earth to the metal DIN rail itself.
Okay, so that clips in, no screws, just clips straight onto the DIN rail.
Yeah. I'm putting an intermediate end plate on. Possibly it's very easy to tell where the earth connections end and the other ones start, but it just creates that nice visual identification between the different section.
Okay, and then we're just gonna repeat the process through as you build it up.
Just build it up, end cap on, and then just start a little bit of wiring.
Okay, so using the push variety of these, so we've got the ones that use the operating slot and we've got the lever in order to make your connections onto the actual DIN rails from Wago.
Yeah, so I mean, easy for anyone who suddenly descends into an alien world and doesn't know what they're looking at and needs to do some maintenance. The little push button is very easy to work with.
You just cut off a ferrule there.
Yeah, so just using the, these are class 5 conductors, so stranded conductors. You don't even really need to twist them to put them into the top job terminals. But again, just...
operating tool, drop it in, connected.
Yeah.
So finish off the rest of the connections for this S-Plan heating system. I think I'll jump back in maybe when you're on that last final connection. So there it goes, last one's in place. What's next?
Next, so just put some jumpers in. So obviously, there's a neutral. We'll use two top job terminals. We need to connect those together. Debate on the earth, what do you think? Obviously, they're linked through the DIN rail.
Yeah, it can make testing a little bit tricky if you were doing individual circuits of all the CPCs are linked there and then go back to another area.
But I definitely need to link the line and the neutral together. And then just putting in some label inserts. So these ones you can write on.
You need a remarkably fine, say, Sharpie pen in order to write something clear on it.
And not your shaky hands. So instead I've gone for I've just printed some off an our Brother label printer. Now really these labels need to be 11 millimeters wide for that. And I suggest Wago have probably got a special printer that we need to try and convince them to give us one off so we can do a better job on that.
Either that or it's Origami Gary with his scalpel blade. So once again, you proved there the Top Job S range from Wago is incredibly fast, incredibly simple, but your rule normally is when you pick an enclosure, you generally pick one enclosure too small for what you actually need. And as I look down here, you've actually given yourself a lot of space.
I know, I've broken my own golden rule. Yeah, well, it's normally when I've completed a job, Gary. I wish I'd chosen one that's, that was a size up. But in this, actually, I think I probably could have gone a size down.
Yeah.
Because I could have obviously brought some of those glands in the side.
Yeah.
It's the glands that need the room, not the terminals, and shifted them along. Now, just for comparison.
Right.
I've got some conventional DIN rail terminals here. So there's 40 connection points in there.
Wow, there's a lot there.
And there's 40. And then if I compare that with a box, so let's get the same size box we've got there, and just the lid, you will see my rule would have been right there. I would have struggled to get those terminals in and allowed myself enough room to route the wires around.
And that's the beauty of this system here, where we haven't got just two connections per DIN rail, have we?
No, so there's four per one, and then these jumper links as well are really easy. And again, you compare them to a standard DIN rail. We've got all these screw connections to make. Check out the video where you'll see Gary attempt to make them, but was thwarted in the process.
You gave me the wrong size screwdriver, and that's why I lost the race.
We'll see. Yeah, so lots of options there. Other options we could have done, we could have brought in some coloured terminals if you again wanted to differentiate those neutral connections.
But that doesn't mean they do them in all the colours, do they?
So we don't.
Yeah, we won't find a brown one, etc., will we? So you've gone with obviously the standard grey there, the green and yellow for our CPC, and you've labelled your terminals accordingly. Just run us through the labels.
Yeah, so obviously, yeah, the E for the obviously earth, the CPC connections, the neutral, eight connections there with the jumper link, obviously to common these two sections together. There's the line connections, but only actually used one terminal, actually, so I could have omitted one.
Right.
And then next to it, there's the connections for the hot water system, so from our cylinder stack, from the timer, then out to the zone valve. The connections from the heating programmer / thermostat to that zone valve, and then obviously the return from the zone valves to fire up the pump and the boiler, which is the P terminal.
Right, okay, we're all over that. You've done that many videos on this S-Blood heating system. He's crushing it, okay. I like that, and I love the way we've gone through that system. We've shown, obviously, it takes up a lot less room, but this isn't the only style of DIN rail connector that we can get from Wago in this Top Job S series, is it?
No, it's not. I mean, there's an immense range that we've looked at in a previous video.
Did we do a deep dive?
We did do a deep dive. Well, no, we didn't. We scratched the surface
because
there are so many different part number combinations in there. So these are just the conventional one in, one out terminals. But yeah, this range has lots of options. You know, obviously, you don't necessarily need to use the push buttons we've used there. You could use the lever style. We've got the clamps, but if this is
the lever style here, and this one down here. Just remind me what tool you need for this style at the end.
Well, that's the operating tool, Gary.
Yeah, the old operating tool. Yeah. Not a screwdriver, folks.
Not a screwdriver.
So we've got our conventional levers we're used to seeing on a Wago connector. We've got the push button we saw in this series, but we've got the ones that use that operating tool as well. So three different ways of doing the same thing. So, and I recommend checking out that video because obviously we have a look at it. Like you said, it's an immense range, but we also suggest where you'd use each of those connectors, maybe in panel building, didn't we?
Yeah, and what I'll do is I will leave a list of the part numbers that we've used in this system. As you know, we love a part number. I love a part number, and this system has a lot of them. That is the only difficult thing about this system is navigating the part numbers.
But the reward is there when you get the stuff come through.
It is, but I'll put a link in the description below if you if you're using a lot of S-plan wiring and you want to recreate what we have here, and I'll link to those other videos for the other components that we have as well.
Yeah, and as always, you'd love some more questions on S-plan heating systems. I think you've even done one where you give people a wiring diagram. You're fully in love with the S-plan heating system. However, this video was about those connectors from Wago, those dim rail ones. Are you currently using the TopJob S-series from Wago as your go-to dim rail connector? Did you not know about it? And now obviously you're thinking, wow, that's so easy. I'm going to start investigating that in the future. Are you using these boxes from Hylec or the Glands? Just remind me of the Glands.
It's the
Kwik Fix Glands. Yeah. Okay, which we've liked, and we've got a video of those on the channel as well. And it helps ensure that IP rating, especially if you're choosing an IP rated enclosure for your central heating system. Please leave all those comments below, and S-Plan Heating System over here will get back to as many as he can.